personally, but it's really great to have you with us. I'm not going to do a lot of talk this evening because you haven't come here to listen to me. You've come here to learn and work with our team of facilitators, which is Ruhia, Leah, Hani, Kararaina, and is that everyone? Yeah. Have I missed anyone? Ruhia, Leah, Kararaina, and Hani, yeah. So with that, I'm going to hand straight over to Ruhia, I believe, who's going to introduce us to what this evening, this afternoon, or this morning is going to be all about. Over to you, Ruhia.
Kia ora.
A huge welcome to everyone.
Kia ora, everyone. Nau mai, hara mai. Welcome to the session tonight. Look, before we get started, and I know that some of us are in different timelines or different time spaces, I'm going to share with you a very short routine, and it's called energy moving. We call it rongo pungao in Māori. And it's about moving our energy so that we can help us to focus. So what I'm going to need you all to do, first of all, and you'll need to listen to the instructions, is you're going to stand up, and the hand that you don't write with, I want you to put your thumb up, and I'm just going to show you. Put your thumb up and you're going to take it away from your body and you're going to turn it as far as you can backwards, and then when you find the point you can't go any further, just remember where it last was, and then we're going to do a little bit of an energy, just energy moving. And it's really about to get the body and the mind come back together so that we can be focused. Sometimes we have where our mind is running ahead of our body, or our body's finding it hard to catch up. So if you're ready, you can stand up. Lift the hand that you don't write with, point it up in front of you so your thumb is pointing up like that, and then turn as far as you can away from your body and keep going until you can't go any further, and try and remember where you last were and come back slowly to the front. Right, now we're going to do some energy moving, and you can do it sitting down or you can stand up. It's really up to you. But the first exercise we're going to do is a fire exercise, and I'll stand up because Leah's still standing. And the fire exercise is you're going to cross the energy around your body. So energy needs to cross. So we're just going to do some crisscrosses. And you can even pull the energy from one side to the other. So you want to cross it over your body. Right, shake that off. Now we're going to do an earth energy. And that's patting on your cheek. And that's so the energy will ground down to Mother Earth. And so you're going to give it a good pat on your cheek. And this is the earth energy. And the next exercise is keep patting on your cheek till I show you. You're going to find your collarbone, and just underneath your collarbone is a little indent. And you're going to tap as hard as you can on that one. And this is opening up your ear energy. And you know you're going to tapping it hard if you vibrate. So you go, ah. And if it hurts, you need it. Keep going. Now we're going to come to the fire energy again. It's the love energy, and it's in between your breasts. And this is the thymus energy. It's for the white blood cells. And you're going to tap that as hard as you can. And open it up. This is your fire energy. And the next exercise, you're going to follow the end of your rib. On the left side is your spleen. On the right side is your liver. And you're going to tap that as hard as you can. And just really open it up. So now you're getting into the earth energy. And give it a good hard tap. And if it hurts, my dears, you'll need some more. Keep doing this. Right, shake it all out. Now this one, we're gonna bring all the four energies together. One hand will go flat up to the sky, and the other hand flat down to the earth. And you're gonna stretch as hard as you can. So you breathe in and push it up and stretch the whole side really as hard as you can, stretch. And then slowly come down to the front again and do the other side, stretch up. As hard as you can, come back down. This will be really good for the person who's going to go and do some training it in another hour's time. Stretch up, down one more. Last one. And then I want you to bend over and just do some figure eights and bring all the energy around your body and take it right up to the heavens, up to the elements. Scoop all that energy around, follow down to your pelvic bone, dip it up to the bottom of your lips, pretend you're locking it with a key, and you're going to give that to the elements. Then push the energy from your back, from your tailbone, push it up. Go over with the other hand, pull that energy to your top lip, lock it and give that to the elements. The last one, one hand in your belly button, pull it up, and the other hand on your third eye, hook it together and breathe in. And out. Breathe in again. And out. And last one. Now we've hooked everything up. This time, take your thumb, put it back out. And then away from your body, follow your thumb right around and see if your energy's moved you to go further. All get further.
Yes.
That point. Give yourselves a wave as an acknowledgement.
It's not you.
So that's what we call rongo pūngo. And it helps to bring all your energies back together for your mind, body, and soul. Mind, body, and soul needs energy. And so there was the earth, air, water, fire energy moving. Welcome, everyone. So the first thing I want you to do before I actually introduce our team, and if you can, is on check that your name is showing up. And also on your name, put the country that you're from and the first letter of the element of your highest element. So as you can see, I've got Ruhia King, NZ, New Zealand, and my highest element that I connect with is water. And I can see Kararaina has got F for fire. So just do that around. And for those who are a bit shy to show their thing, one of the things that we like when we're doing virtual learning online is we encourage everyone to show their video so we can see who we are connecting with. But if it's because of internet connection, I understand if you can't put your video on. But I do encourage you all to put your video on so we can see face to face and who we are talking to. Kia ora. Right. I'm going to introduce our team. The people that's in the room with us are all TetraMap certified facilitators. And we all work for the same company called Te Wānanga Aotearoa. And we have been very privileged to be able to have be part of this wonderful journey, TetraMap, alongside Yoshimi and John. And a big mihi to you, Yoshimi and John. Thank you for being here tonight. What a privilege it is to have you amongst us. And so now this is to my left. Over here on my screen is Leah. She's probably somewhere else on your screen, but she's waving out. So Leah, you want to just give a big hello?
Kia ora, everybody. Nga mihi nui kia koutou. Lovely to be here.
Ka tuku te rākau ki a Kararaina, and she's down in here in this corner on my screen.
Kia ora koutou, I'm Kararaina and I come from the east coast in Aotearoa, New Zealand, of the North Island.
And I'm going to do a couple of jumps over. One, two, and I'm down to Hani, who's right at the bottom of my screen.
Tēnā koutou e ngā matatini o te ao. Tēnei te mihi nui ki a koutou, mai i a hau Hani, Hamilton, New Zealand. Big welcome to all the many faces of the world. Kia ora.
And I'm going to do just because it really, I need to do a shout out to, I'm going to go one, two over to my cousin Connie, who's sitting over right there. And she used to also work for us at Te Wānanga Aotearoa too.
Oh, kia ora e te whānau. So good to see everybody.
And so, all TetraMap certified facilitators, I'm very grateful, excited that Hani and Kara are working towards their masters. And I did my masters a few years ago and have thoroughly enjoyed that thing. All the trainers in Te Wānanga Aotearoa were trained while working at the Wānanga. So kia ora. Now we're going to start our evening, our morning, our afternoon, wherever you are, with a karakia. And I'm going to ask Hane is going, so listen. Oh, I want to jump over there and say hello to Katarina. I can just see you. Kia ora, Katarina. And I know you've got a beautiful voice, so please sing along with Hane. Hane is going to actually sing our karakia. Now, karakia for us is an acknowledgement to our spiritual guides. It is also an acknowledgement to the elements, to the environment, and an acknowledgement to everyone that is here and all your ancestors and people that come with you. So tēnā koe, Hane. And if you like, you can watch along while she's singing. Kara's, and I'll sign for you. Ka pai, Hane.
All right, testing, 1, 2, 3. Whakataka te hau ki te uru. Whakataka te hau ki te tonga. Kia makina kina ki uta. Kia matara tara ki tai. Ehi ake ana te atakura, he tio, he huka, he hau. Tihe mauri ora. Tihe mauri ora.
You're on mute, Ruhia.
Whenever we do virtual training, or any types of training, we always open up with either through a karakia, a prayer, an acknowledgement, and as you heard from Hane doing, we can even sing our way, our karakia. So I hope you enjoyed that little thing. That's to open us up, to connect us with our spiritual guides and our element guides. Kia ora. So I'm going to ask Kara now to put the video. Share her screen. So I just wanted to show you, and you're going to see as we go through the program, how we got involved with TetraMap, and how it really connects and resonates with us as the indigeneity of New Zealand. And so this model here is the Tapatoru. And this model was introduced to me by my parents and also my grandfather. And so the first there, you'll see mana, Māori, tapu noa, which means the strength. Every person that you have contact with comes with their own strength, their own energy, their own restricted spaces and harmony. The second one, on the side here, you'll see, and it says the word whenua. Now, if you're struggling with the Māori word, whenua is earth. And then in the green, you've got HAA, which is ha, and that's our air element. The blue is wai, that's our water element. And in the middle is ahi, which is our fire element. So my parents always taught me that whenever we're doing anything, we must always remember to connect with the environment. And this is what Mum said to me. You need to make sure you connect with the environment. You need the sustenance of the earth to keep you strong. You need the air that you breathe, because without the oxygen, you will die. You need water in your body. Over 80% of your body is made up of water, and you need the sun for the energy. And on the other side there is, you'll see a big long word starting with P, which says Papatūānuku. And that's the Māori word for our earth mother. And in the green, you'll see the letter start, the word starting with T, Tāwhirimātia, which is the Māori word for the wind guide, our spiritual guide, Tāwhirimātia. And he looks after the wind and all of that. And then in the blue is Rona, and she looks after all the waterways that we have connection with the land, the lakes, the rivers, and even the rain. And right in the middle is Tamanui Te Rā, and he is the guardian of the sun. And so the tapatoru makes up the frame. There's 1, 2, 3. And you've got in the middle there, it says Tuakiri o te tangata. Basically, it's the elements of the person. You need the mind, spirit, and the body. And mind, body, and soul. It's all of those things connected. And what I really loved about this, the tapatoru, is when I first saw TetraMap, and I thought, wow, this is just so like what we already do. Because when you take it out of the tapatoru, you can turn it into a TetraMap. And we'll go to the next slide, Kara. And then so this, you saw the tapatoru, and if you flip it around, take just one out, and you connect it to the end, you've now got the TetraMap. And that's how we saw that what we were already practicing really resonated and engaging with TetraMap. So thank you very much, Yoshini and John. You gave us what we call a gift, a taonga. And if we go to the next slide, please, Kara. And so through this presentation, we're going to focus on fourth, aku wānanga is our quality teaching, learning, and living. So I had my first TetraMap introduction back in 2011, became a certified facilitator in that same year, and then a couple of years later, looked at becoming a master TetraMap. The organization where I worked with has allowed us to actually TetraMap our whole, our values and all of that, and I'm going to let the rest of the family talk about that. But the first, the earth element there is whanaungatanga. Whanaungatanga is having respectful relationships and connections. The second one is living and learning. That's our ako. Aro is our reflective practice. And te hiringa is the passion and motivation and spirituality. So we have whanaungatanga, our connections, our ako, aro, and te hiringa. And those are our practices of excellence for teaching and learning. And so we follow these guides in everything that we do around teaching and learning. And as we go through, you're going to see how we've made the connections. Right in the middle there, you'll see the logo, Te Wānanga o Te Rō. That's our Wānanga logo. And we just wanted to also acknowledge that TetraMap is there, and then the Tapatoru logo on the other side. And so, a very brief intro from me, because I want you to hear also now from Leah.
Oh, well, tēnā tātou, nā mihi nui kia tātou, ko hui hui mai nei, ngā hau e whā o te ao. This is a really, amazing to be feel very privileged to be here sharing in this kaupapa this evening, and wonderful to meet you all from all the different far-flung corners of the world. And I just want to acknowledge John and Yoshimi and Louise and the whānau of TetraMap, and also my colleagues. I have sort of been in and out over the last few years, so it's lovely just to come back and share. But my role this evening is really just to give you a bit of a context, a little bit more context about our organisation, so that you can see the alignment that Ruhia has been talking about in a little bit more detail in terms of the values of our organisation. I come from Rotorua. I live in Rotorua, New Zealand. It's, well, it was formerly a tourist mecca, but not so much now at the moment. But anyway, we onwards and upwards, as they say. Te wānanga o Aotearoa, I've been in the organisation almost 20 years now. And I came across TetraMap in about 2015, which was when I started working with Ruhia and Hani Kara in our Ako Wānanga team. And it was Ruhia who introduced us to this amazing kaupapa. And so Te Wānanga o Aotearoa, basically we're a tertiary provider, a national provider in Aotearoa. We've been around for 35 years, and we started as a little community project, really, in the 80s, in a response to particularly Māori young people who were our Indigenous young people who were not having a really great time at school and being suspended and expelled. And so our founders created this little community project to work with those tamariki, those kids. And over the years, it has grown and grown and grown into this a national provider of tertiary education. So now we have over 120 sites of delivery around the country. We have certificate programs. There's Waipa Kokiri, that's what we started as, the little community space for the kids to come and learn about Māori traditional art practices like carving and weaving, and a place where they could be valued for who they are as Māori. They started there at Waipa Kokiri Art Centre, and now the same building has transformed into what we know today at our head office there. So it's an amazing history. If you ever get a chance, you can go on the website and have a really good look. But it's very inspiring, the whole story. So now, we deliver certificates, from certificates right up until master's level programs now. We deliver a lot of course, mātauranga Māori programs, our Māori language programs and the arts and cultural practices. But also we do a varied, you know, lots of other things, business, computing, social work, teaching, there's quite a range. And the pedagogy that we use is called Ako Wānanga, and Ruhia has already introduced you to the four key, I guess, attributes of best practice in that space: whanaungatanga, connections, ako, aro, and te heringa. And so our pedagogy has grown over the years. It developed over about 20 years in just from action and reflection and experience and what's working and what doesn't work. And eventually we've come up with this amazing pedagogy, which has our founding kaupapa, our founding philosophy, to provide holistic education of the highest quality to Māori, but also peoples of Aotearoa and the world. And then we have our guiding values here, and you can see that we've aligned them to the TetraMap. These are our values that guide the way we conduct ourselves. We have a set of principles that also help us to operationalize our values, to make them live in our practice, like kaitiakitanga, which is to look after or to be a guardian of knowledge, but of also looking after one another. Koha, is around reciprocity and everything that we can offer one another and also take from one another in a reciprocal relationship. But always in a space of ahurutanga, which is a safe and nurturing space to learn together and in pursuit of mauri ora, which is that whole well-being, spiritual, physical, the well-being of family as well. So all of the balance that the elements provide. And we will be delving into these attributes of best practice that we've already introduced, whanangatanga, ako, aro, and tehiringa. So all of these things have come together and been layered on top of one another over the years, and this is what we've found as an organization really works for our students and our staff. And the framework that pulls all of these things together is in the shape of a whare, or a house, an ancestral house like this one that you can see. And the idea is that at any time, as a staff member of Te Wānanga o Aotearoa, or a student, I can go and sit in the back of my house and just reflect on whether all of those attributes are present in my practice, or whether the values are present in my practice. Every one of those elements has a place in the house. So the walls of the house have the values, the posts in the house have the attributes of best practice, and so on. And so it's now a place of reflection where I can just sit and reflect and make sure that all of those elements are there in my practice. And when we started, it was about the practice of teaching, but as we learnt along the way, it was actually about just practice of life. And it doesn't really matter what your role is. That's where you can bring all of those elements into your practice. So that's our guiding pedagogy, our guiding framework at the Wānanga. And the alignment with TetraMap was just so easy and natural. And you can already, I guess, see from Ruhia's kōrero earlier about why that happened so easily, because te ao Māori, the Māori world, already had those same connections to the elements. So that's really, just wanted to give you a bit of a context about our organisation. And of course, we're grappling with this new online world in delivery. Most of the time our students like to be face-to-face, so this has been a challenge for us too. But we'll be able to share with you some of the tips and tricks that we've learnt along our journey. So that's it from me. Thank you. Ngā mihi. I'll be checking in again a bit later, but kia ora. Kia ora, everyone.
And we're going to move to Hani. Oh, sorry, no, is it? Yeah, it is Hani, eh? Yes. Ka pai kara.
Ka pai, tēnā tātou. Tēnā koe Lia I ērā kōrero. He mihi hoki kia kōrua. John, kōrio kōrio shimi, ki te kōre kōrua, ka kōre tēnei āhuatanga e tau mai nei ki mui I a tātou. So just want to really acknowledge John and Yoshimi for this taonga, as Ruhia said, and for setting it into the environment, into te taiao, because that's the basis of almost our own selves and our own beings. And so just reinforcing what Leah and Ruhia have said, how much of a natural alignment this was to our whare. So just to start off with, we're going to look at what we call our Māori continuum. And as you can see the description up here, Māori for us, it's a life principle, a life force. That's the biggest force that you can have, that one, how it's felt there. So vital essence, again, of everybody. And we said best practice is all striving towards Māori order, towards our tauira, our kaimahi, our students, and the people that we work with. all being in the best possible place that they can be. And what I like to say is that if Māori Order is present, then you know that as long as anybody that comes into your space leaves better than when they arrived, then I feel through TetraMap we've done our mahi. So this is the Māori continuum, and what we're going to get you all to do is use annotate, and we're just going to, I'm just going to run through, because like with all our tauira, we don't assume that everybody knows how to use annotate. It was certainly a big lesson for our tauira and for our students and our teachers engaging in this space. So again, on your screen, you'll have view options. If you press onto view options and you'll see annotate or anotate, as we call it. If you press on anotate, and you'll see the stamp. So what I'm going to do is, on this continuum, I want you to put on there where you think you sit as far as your
She's just frozen a bit, so I'll just pick it up until she comes back. Select the heart. We'll start with the heart, perhaps. And if you select the heart stamp, go on into the Māori continuum and mark where you think you are with cultural protocols in a virtual delivery. Māori moe down below is untapped potential, or are you an awakened potential, or are you at realized
standing potential? Or knowings?
Keep going, honey.
Oh, awesome. Tino pai. Tēnā te pai o tēnei mahi. That's why we like to work together. It's about here tō takitini, bringing everybody's strengths and skills to the table. So thank you, everybody's putting up where they think they sit. So Māori moi, just to go through, for us, we say that everyone comes to us with untapped potential. So they're just leaving, that potential within them just needs to be woken up. And so that's Māori moi. That's I might know a little bit or nothing at all. Māori noho, now we've come out of the sleep space, we're sitting up now and we're looking around. So we've awakened that potential with us and that desire to know a bit more. So now we're in a bit more of a knowing space, and now we're into Māori too. And now we're standing up. A bit like Darwin's theory, we start down here and work our way up. But again, Māori too is our space of realised potential. So yes, we know some stuff, we've learnt our mahi, gone through what we know, we understand what we've been shown and what we've been taught, or what we've had in our wānanga and our learning space, and we're in a good space there. Māori Ora is when you know the know, and you do the do, and you're out there transforming others through your own practice. And so that's the Māori Order space. And it's a continuum, because depending on the environment or the subject matter or the activity that we're involved in, we could all be anywhere on that continuum. Why are we doing this now? When we come to the end of our presentation this evening, we're going to come back to, we're going to revisit the Māori continuum and have a look where you sit. Where you put yourselves there with your little hearts, with your manawa, you're putting your heart on your sleeve there. What you're going to do at the end of it is that we're going to have another look and see if there's been any shift. Okay, Tupai, sorry, I just thought people froze for a minute there, but you're just attentive. Ka pai, so we'll come back to this. We will revisit this a bit later on in the picture. And I'm now going to pass it back to Ruhia. Thanks for picking that up, Ruhia.
Ka pai, Kani. So our next presenter is going to be Kararaina. So you've heard from Leah, who approached it from an air element, Hani did the water element, and now Kararaina is going to present from an earth element.
Kia ora koutou. Kia ora again, hello. What I'm going to be talking about is whanaungatanga and the importance of whanaungatanga, which for Māori is building and maintaining respectful relationships and connections, and how and why that is important for us to do it, whether we are delivering virtually or whether we're delivering face-to-face. So for our Māori culture, building whanaungatanga, making those relationships and connections is an integral value for us, so that we connect and build relationships with each other, but also with our environment. Whanaungatanga, or relationship building, allows us to respect and acknowledge those that we are with, themselves. We can acknowledge where they come from, who they descend from, their genealogy, and we also can respect and acknowledge their land, their mountain, their rivers, their sea, from which they descend from, and also have a spiritual connection to. And so in any aku space, a teaching and learning space, I mentioned before, there's many ways that we can do that. Building those relationships and assisting our participants make meaningful connections with each other helps them to feel a sense of belonging, helps them to feel, as we would all know, with the high water element, helps them to feel relaxed and comfortable in the learning and teaching space, the aku space, and helps them to interact and engage with each other, and often share, you know, their opinions or their thoughts with each other, because there's no fear to share those. And we can do that, help our participants to connect emotionally, to connect physically, to connect spiritually, in many different ways. And so I've got a couple of activities for us to do. And the first is, I know that we have written down where each of us are at the moment on our names, but it'd be also nice to see where we all come from as well on the map here. So you'll see we've got all of the ao here, the world, and I do have a big Aotearoa, and it's not to say we're any significant than anybody else, it's just I knew that there would probably be more people from New Zealand, so I've put this map up here. But I thought I'd invite you to get the heart stamp again and to place that stamp where you come from, where you are in the world. So we can visually see how far and wide we all are, how far and wide and distance we are. Oh, awesome. Wow. Oh, we've got two down there. Well, this is awesome to be able to physically see where you all are sitting at the moment, or where you all come from. And I wanted to acknowledge again everybody that's got up early in the morning, or if it's late at night or in the middle of the night, for some of us, thank you for joining in. Thank you for sharing in this space. Thank you for being a part of this learning, because in any learning space, we are all learners and teachers at the same time. This is great to see where everybody is. One of the things in our thinking in Te Ao Māori, in our Māori way of thinking, is that we are connected to each other through the land, through our mountains, and also through the land connects us. But we don't see an ocean as something that disconnects us or separates us, because our ocean still connects us all together as well. The same tides that reach your shores and tickle your toes and dance along your shores are the exact same tides that come our way and also greet us. And so to think about our moana, our oceans, also are what connect us together. So thank you for sharing that. Just wanted to have a look at where we all come from. I'm just going to quickly save that. And the second thing that I wanted to share for our whanaungatanga to help us connect even more, so we've seen where we are from on the map, we can read it on our names as well. We've seen also some of you have introduced yourselves in the chat and told us where you are. It's for you, for some of us to have the opportunity to share your taonga. So we invited you all to bring a cultural taonga, a cultural treasure, something that is really important to you, Perhaps it's something that's really of a value to your family. It could be something that's passed, been handed down to you, gifted to you. And hopefully you've all brought something along, and I thought I would invite you all just to hold them up to the screen so we can have a look at those, whatever they are, or your special taonga. I can see Hani's showing her moko kowai. Oh, wow. Oh, beautiful, Trish. Oh, wow, Kitty. Wow, I can see some real special taonga that people are holding up. These are awesome. And I thought I would just give the opportunity, because I know we are running out of time, but I just thought if one person would like to share whatever your taonga is with us, we'll allow you this time to share that, if there's anybody that would like to.
This is from my mother's Shinto shrine that was in our house since I was born.
And this is a wind vane from my dad that my dad designed and installed on the old house, but we've dismantled the old house and we built a new one. So I'm creating my own version of it. Out of copper recycled from the building.
Okay. Wow, those are amazing. Thank you so much, Yoshimi and John, for sharing those with us. And if we'd have more time, I'd love for everybody else to share these. But Leah, did you have something you were gonna say?
I was just gonna say, when we go into the breakout rooms, you'll have a chance to share in your little groups, your taonga.
Cool, thanks. So there's a couple of activities that we've done that shows you how you can help to do whanaungatanga, or continue to do that, I should say, because I'm sure we're all doing that virtually and being able to connect each other in those different ways. So I'm going to pass it over. So that's our whanaungatanga. I'm going to pass it over to Hani to do our hot tips. So some hot tips on some things for you to consider when we're delivering virtually.
Ka pai. So while that's coming up, during the rahui, which is what we called it, during the lockdown, one of the spaces, of course, that our aku wānanga team, we quickly, so I'm sure many of us did,
oh gosh, we've lost Hani again.
Over that time and space. Oh, there I am back. Am I back? Yep,
you're back. No, gone again, Hani. Maybe I can pick up.
Yeah, pick it up.
Okay. So, yeah, obviously we were all thrown into the lockdown world, everyone around the world.
Back. Kapai. Oh, no, that's right. I'll just, I'm going to go in on here.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yep. Cool, Hani. You're back.
Oh, ka pai. Actually, in the meantime, I'm going to get my son to get my phone ready. So our tips that we used our best practice, as Leah probably just said, using whanaungatanga, ako, aro, and te heringa. So you've already heard whanaungatanga, respectful relationships, living ako, living, learning, and teaching all in one. Aro, reflective practice, not just reflection, but doing something about that. And te heringa, which is all the awesomeness that everybody brings to the space with their passion and their own motivation to motivate those around them. Because as we know, e hara taku toa I te toa takitahi, engari he toa takitini, which translates together, everyone achieves more. So e hara taku toa, my strength is not
the strength of one, but the strength of many.
Many. Yeah.
And so it's like looking at the tetrahedron. When you look at the tetrahedron, you need all four to
one. Engari he toa takitini. kapai. Oh, awesome. Awesome job jumping in and backing in. Thank you. So for Naingatanga, our tip there for today, and this is aligned specifically to this space. Just wait for that to come up. So we always say, so again, for Naingatanga, have you contacted your participants? We all received emails today to ensure that we're all part of this space. Reached out to them to make sure they're ready to engage with you online. So again, just doing a little bit of mahi, a little bit of work before actually getting online, and also providing opportunities for our participants to build relationships and make connections with each other. And that was demonstrated, of course, by Nu here right at the beginning, and Kara with the exercises, or little exercises that we had there, using either the rename or showing your cultural taonga. Consider inviting a participant to open and close your session through their cultural practices. As an example, our master TetraMap facilitation, wānanga, I won't call it a class, our wānanga that we had last week, Louise brought along a karakia, and she asked, would anyone like to say that?
And I believe Hani gave it back to Louise.
That karakia, or use our own, and... Awesome, she did. She gave it back to Louise and said, this is mahuru Māori, whakamātou here, give it a go, and she did, and that was awesome. So just another way to allow people to bring their own culture into the space. Moving on to ako and our learning space. So again, don't forget, for us, ako is living, learning and teaching all in one. So that your participants get the best out of their learning, do you know how to teach them how to use Zoom? So that was one of the things, of course, we discovered, that most people are really good with their kaupapa, their knowledge base and what they're sharing. However, not everyone knows how to use Zoom. So we incorporated all the little techniques into our trainings. So we integrated them in, so it wasn't like, this is how you do this. We integrated into the training and got them to work with the activities. Allowing time and space for participants to share their learning, knowledge and experience together. So again, we're not assuming that this is not happening, but it's using our four huanga. We know that if all these things are happening, Māori Ora is the outcome. Being in the best space that you can be is the outcome. Prepare to learn about the cultural protocols of your participants before the session. So sometimes, of course, I've noticed with all our TetraMap sessions, regardless of what they've been online, we're allowed to go on a little bit earlier. We can sit down and have a bit of a wānanga, a bit of a discussion. And again, we usually get asked, so is there anything particular you'd like to do or like to work with? So again, just being really conscious of that again, there might be reasons why some people aren't doing certain things, or doing things that you haven't seen before. Ka pai, coming into aro, as I said, lovely having the water there in our space, and it's there because we can say, me aro tō mata ki te wai. You must look at your own reflection in the water and see what comes back. And so aro and its reflective practice, check in with your participants regularly during your delivery. So again, every time I go out, my mates are texting me to say you're frozen, and so they can take over and drop into that space. So again, just check, so you know, how are you guys? And again, even if it's just looking around the screens as we do, making sure that people are involved. Invite the participants to reflect on and share examples of the significance of each element to them in their culture. If I hark back to what Ruhia did at the beginning again, and just talking about how, and Leah, how this naturally aligns to our culture and to our thinking and our worldview. So again, being able to share that. Provide opportunities for participants to reflect on and connect to their learning. So again, sometimes in this space, we just think we just talk, and then we may not have any engagement, so we don't really know where people are at, and they might not know themselves. So allowing them to either use the annotate or use something or into the breakout rooms to have those discussions to come back. We found that that was especially essential for us, as Ruhia mentioned, our tauira. There's a reason that they come physically to us, is because face-to-face is how they operate best, the majority. So we can enhance that experience for them by knowing how to use the tools and engaging them in the space. Te hiring, of course, all of that kind of sometimes means not too much if it's not an exciting place to be. Now, Ran and one of our participants in our course, mentioned that what she loves about TetraMap is the fact that, one, and we all know this, people are already starting to use it and think about it as a tool during the training. They don't even have to wait till the end of it. They're already starting to work in that space, and the way that we work and are able to use the tools and work with the space, it's fun and it's engaging. And that's how what we've found with our participants is that keeping it fun and engaging and active, that's the tehiringa coming out. That's our fire space. So again, that's our fire space there, all that passion and motivation, and that we're just rocking it. And then we help our other elements help to make sure that we're rocking it forward. Not
so she's just dropped out for a moment there. So the hearing aid, you saw the action that I did was this, and it's kind of like the celebration action. And so that's why we gave it that action, the hearing aid. It's like that aha moment. The moments where you where something just clicks for you. And we'll carry on there, Kara.
Oh, yep, those are the tips.
Yeah. Thank you. And so I'm just looking at the time and mindful of the time at 7:56, which doesn't leave us much more. So what we're going to do is just... we're
all over the place in different spaces, and we're all moving in the same... Awesome, Ruhia. Thanks for finishing that off.
No point. So what we're going to do is we're going to put you in a breakout room just for a few minutes, and you're going to know which breakout room you're in, because you'll either be in Whanaungatanga, which is Earth. You'll be in one of those four rooms. And when you're in the room, come back with a hot tip for cultural protocols in a virtual learning space. Share your taonga with your friends in the room, and then come back with a hot tip for one of those activities. All right. Thank you, Louise. So, I don't know, are you still there with us, Louise?
Sure. Yes, I sure am. I'm pressing open all rooms and it's not working for me. So
we'll just stop dealing.
Okay.
We have this little saying, if it doesn't work,
it's not meant to be.
Wait a minute.
I'm going to bring us all together now.
And wait a minute.
It's all right, Louise. We won't go there now.
Sure. I can do it now. I've realized I had to do it manually. Up to you.
I think we'll bring us together, because there's just a couple of things I want to share on this, and since we've only got a couple of minutes left.
Okay.
One of the things that I liked about this TetraMap, the tetrahedron, when it falls down to a tetrahedron, and I share with our staff, and I think if you're an earth element and your strength is down here, and when you get into stress, you move up to the point here. And I let them have a look at what the other two elements that are connected to it. So if I'm earth and I move and I'm starting to stress, I'm moving up. I look over and I can see the air element is there and the fire element. So I'd say to my friends, go outside and get some fresh air. Get the sun on you. And if you're in the air element and you're starting to stress, you can see the earth and the water is connected. So go and do some gardening. Or maybe go to the beach, connect with water, connect with earth. And so this is the power of this tetrahedron. So do feel free to share that with your things. And the other thing is that we didn't get a chance to show you, but with the Hani shared with you. E hara I te toa I te toa takitini, engari he toa takitahi. When all of them are working, you will work as a team. It'll provide strength. My mother gave a proverb, I guess a saying, and she said, when one of these elements is missing, the body becomes unwell. You need the fire for the energy. You need the water. You need the air and you need the earth. And when they are all connected, you have a tetrahedron and you are working well and everything is working in unison with everything else. So that's a little hot tip on how to use the wooden thing, tetrahedron. And I can see we're on 8 o'clock now, so I'm just going to give a little, and it's just an opportunity because Yoshimi and John are in the room, just to what we call hand the rākau over. And I'd like to hand the rākau over to our founders, Yoshimi and John, to share with us, and just an acknowledgement to you both. Kia ora.
Kia ora.
What an incredible hour.
Awesome.
That was such a gem. All four of you, thank you so much. And I know several places I'd love you to repeat this hour in our new communities we're working with. It was just, you encapsulate, you crystallized it in an hour. And so I thank you very much. And so respectful because, you know, we feel there's always been a connection with Ruhia and the team. So thank you very much.
Yeah, and I've been recently discovering, I mean, I've always understood intuitively how the ancient wisdom of the Maori is something we need to learn. But I've discovered from some physicists how accurate a lot of the Maori understandings are. And one of the key things I've just discovered is that there's a new theory about the nature of reality, and it's to do with unfolding and folding up. And the TetraMap is a great example of how, when you look at reality, it's all these four different things, these fragmented things. But when you fold it up intuitively, not physically, intuitively, the universe's knowledge is, and unconsciously, it's all one. So it's that reality is the combination of the tetrahedron unfolding into the TetraMap and back again all the time. And what we experience is the TetraMap, but what we understand is the tetrahedron. And it's just what the Maori speak about.
John and I did three space camp classes this year at Buckminster Fuller Institute. It was all online. And one session was about ancestral intelligence, ancestral wisdom. And it was out of the United States. So there was a lot about the American Indians, North American Indians. And when we went to Mexico, we met with an Aztec, and we shared TetraMap with him. And the conference we went to, his dance group, Aztec dance group, did a whole earth, air, water, fire dance. And it was, so there's so much in this ancestral wisdom, ancestral intelligence for us still to learn. So thank you so much again for sharing.
Yeah, thank you.
From your heart.
To one and our team.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for that. You should...
You've gone on mute through here.
Sorry. Just wanted to do a big shout out to Yoshimi and John. Thank you for your sharing tonight. this morning, this afternoon, wherever you are. And thank you to Leah, Hani, and Kararaina for coming in to do a group presentation. And a big shout out to you, Louise, for allowing us to do this and sharing out how we find TetraMap in Te Wānanga o Aotearoa. And so what we're going to do now is close the session with a karakia, a prayer, an acknowledgement. And Kararaina is putting up the words for you. Hani, do you want to read it out for Kara, and then I'll just sign it.
Ai, Maku, I will. Tuia I runga, tuia I raro, tuia I roto, tuia I waho, kia mau, kia u, ki ngā uara, ki ngā takepū o kaupapa wānanga, ki ngā huanga o aku wānanga. Kia tūtuki ai te whakakitenga, te koromakinga, me te kaupapa o te wānanga o Aotearoa. Tūturu whiti whakamaua kia tīna, tīna, haumie, huie, tāiki.
Tāiki.
Hi, Mariri. Have a wonderful night, everyone. Thank you for joining us.
Kia ora.
Thank you, everybody.
Kia
ora. Thank you.
Mariri.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Thanks, Mark. Kia ora.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, kia ora, Louise.
Kia ora, Trish. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
How's your moko?
Oh, growing. Like they do.
Yeah. No, absolutely stunning, as always.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for being such a valuable participant and advocate, as you always are. Thanks, Trish.
That's a beautiful way to spend the evening. So
yeah, beautiful. Kia ora, Trish.
Yeah, whānau o Wānanga o Aotearoa. Pō mārie.
Oh, pō mārie.
Mārie. Tēnā mārie.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Hi, Leticia.
Ka pai. Very nice.